Mike Tyson there. He's one of two players with 5 Super Bowl rings. Do you think he's has the right, I guess, to say this current crop of Cowboys are losers, Max?
No. And let me tell you what the problem is. You know, he's saying they need their head in the playbook, they need to stay off Twitter and these kind of things. Maybe, whatever. But that's not the issue. You know what the issue is? They don't have Charles Haley. I mean, like, right now, he could probably get on the field. He's 50-something, get on the field right now, be their best defensive player. The problem with the Cowboys is the defense. That's the problem. And then there was like a turnover and problems on the offensive line this year that didn't help. But the defense is the problem with the Cowboys. They need a Charles Haley, at least one of them. And Jerry Jones knows this. Remember the War Daddy quote from this last season?
Oh, we need I'll a War Daddy. It.
Right. He's talking about Charles Haley. Charles, it's not that they're not concentrating or not trying hard enough. It's that they're not good enough. The defensive players aren't talented enough. The Dallas Cowboys have invested heavily in the offense, and the defense has suffered as a result, and that's what it is.
Go on ahead, Stephen A. Go ahead and get it all out.
I got to tell you, Will, mm-hmm. I'm not joking about the Cowboys anymore. It's really not funny to me. It's funny during the football season when I watch them lose pivotal games on a Sunday afternoon. But during this time of year, it's not really funny. I don't know if Charles Haley was completely cogent and lucid. He sounded a little bit off to me, to be quite honest with you. But he's not wrong. Because I think that what he's talking about, you know, first of all, it's not really about them being damn losers because they haven't won the Super Bowl. It's about where their priorities appear to lie. Time and time and time again, we see them interested in headlines. Time and time and time again, we see them sacrifice the productivity of this franchise because of off-the-field matters. Ezekiel Elliott with the whole domestic violence thing and what have you, you know what? That was just one story. How about the bigger story about how he wanted to fight, how Jerry Jones had pushed the fight all along, in all likelihood, if you listen to folks in the NFL, because he was told by Roger Goodell that there would be no suspension, and all of a sudden Roger Goodell turned around and suspended Ezekiel Elliott. How about the years and years of times where Jerry Jones and the Dallas Cowboys have made news and headlines for all the wrong reasons? Even now when we sit here, we talked about Dez Bryant yesterday. What are we talking about here? You got to a point where Will Cain, noted Dallas Cowboy fan, you know, native Texan, comes on national TV and says, Dez Bryant ain't worth it. Who the hell doesn't know that? We all know that. But you know what? The Cowboys make things interesting because that's what they're interested in doing. It's what they do. They do it all the time. And that's the damn shame of it all. They can't help themselves. And that's where things become so problematic. Because when Haley says what he says, he may have been wrong in terms of specifics, but generically speaking or in general, mm-hmm. what he's saying is absolutely correct. It's stuff that just permeates their thoughts and just suffocates their mind and it always has something to do beyond the field of play. Winners are focused on what takes place on the field. The Dallas Cowboys seem to be focused on everything else. That has been their history in recent memory, and that's their problem.
The reason I told you to go ahead and get it out and go first is because, honestly, I knew that I'd end up saying something like this today. Mostly, Stephen A., you're right. Max, on the defense and whatnot, you know, every year it's something new. It's the defense one year, it's quarterback play another year, it's something else. And don't worry, by, you know, time the draft rolls around, I'll start looking for the minute problems, the specifics that are why the Cowboys will or will not be great next year, because they should be. That's the whole point. When you add it up, they should be. And Charles Haley's wrong in this respect. It's, you know what, Dak Prescott's not a loser. Honestly, Dez Bryant's not a loser. Ezekiel Elliott's not a loser. The players on that team aren't losers.
Coach is a loser. What's,
there no, it is.
Fans are the losers.
It is.
Oh, my God.
Max, I'm trying to have a reasonable conversation here, okay? I'm trying
to... obviously, if you root for a losing team for 20-something years, it makes you a loser with respect to that team.
Enjoy your fourth pick in the draft or second or whatever it is. I don't even know. But just enjoy that winner. So let me tell you this. The problem is Jerry Jones, okay, Stephen A.? You hinted at it. It's a culture of lack of accountability. You can allow things to become distractions. Jerry put it in his profile that we had here at ESPN. When you're not producing on the field, you give some sizzle to the steak. You make it smell good. He talked about Howard Johnson's and how they used to, if it doesn't taste good, make it hot, hotter than hot. He's into the marketing. He's into all that. And the truth of the matter is he's allowed mediocrity to reign for too many years. It'll always be something different. It'll always be something new. And the truth of the matter is it shouldn't be the case that out of 16 teams in the NFC over the last 20 years, only four haven't made the Super Bowl. And one of those is the Dallas Cowboys. There are 25 teams that have won more than two playoff games over the last 20 years. 25 teams. The Cowboys aren't among them. This is one of the most prestigious franchises in NFL history. Max, you can try to take that away. You can try to wipe away five Super Bowls, eight appearances. But, you know, the problem is you have to be my age to remember them now. You have to be my age to know why this isn't acceptable. And it's not acceptable. And it has to go. Your famous saying, you love it, Max, fish rots from the head down. It's about Jerry and the culture. The loser, Charles Haley, isn't the players. The loser is the culture and accountability that Jerry has allowed to persist. And it goes from there down to Jason Garrett. The players are honestly the last problem.
And the issue with the Cowboys, I'm not wiping away their Super Bowls, Will. When you talk about the greatest franchises in the history of American team sports, when a certain amount of time goes by, and that happens to everyone, even the Yankees, who are by far, it's not even close, the greatest franchise of them all, 27 championships, went from the mid-60s to 1977, no World Series there. That's over 10 years, so it happens to everyone. And then again from 78 to 96. But you need those little bridges. You need revivals. Even if you never recapture former glory totally, and the Yankees actually surpassed former glory at one point, but the point is you need to remain a powerhouse. You need to be in the mix. And the Cowboys have spent a quarter century now, not in the mix. And I'm sorry, they're the most popular franchise in football. They're the most popular franchise in football remain, although I don't know for how much longer. But they can no longer be considered among the real elite greatest franchises in the history of American team sports based on the record.
They have Dak and Zeke. They're going to be all right, guys. I think we're being a little
I'm all back in this next year.
Yes. We glossed over a pivotal moment in the show, though. Did you hear Stephen A. compliment you? He described you as a noted Dallas Cowboys fan.
I don't even know if that was a compliment.
That was a very sweet moment.
I don't know if that was a compliment, but I will acknowledge for the record, I appreciate what he said about the players not being losers. Yes, I'm a noted Cowboy hater, but I'm not knocking the players individually.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the culture of the team. It's really, really a problem. It's like anything to win, but they don't win while allowing anything to happen. That makes no sense.
Yeah, but I think they have the right guy under the helm with the right mindset, Dak Prescott. Will, we'll see you a little